You know, I've dealt with all national assemblies from 1999 to date. And let me confess that this National Assembly has a lot of activists, not just activists, but activists that are showing commitment and ready to achieve results. People may not be aware that the National Health Act, when it was National Health Bill, in 2011, you may not be aware that to get National Health Bill passed the first time in 2011, after 9 years or 7 years, the National Assembly, despite the fact that we also took them to various retreats, made a special visit to all the key officers, and I was in all of them, never considered it an important document. And towards the end of the government in 2011, the only thing we could do, because we spoke, I was on that red line with the chairman of Senate Committee on Health and One of the House, but they had to force our hands. And we had to go and bring out 3,000 market women to go naked at National Assembly for that deal to be passed 1 week towards the end of that National Assembly. Because we sat down and said, if they go, by what we understand, once the bills that are not passed in this, class of this, in the next one, you have to start afresh. You have to pull out women. And they thought it was a joke. They got there. They refused to open the gate. The security said, why are people with their dress? They said, look, if you don't let us in, we'll be here and we'll be naked. So they knew it was serious. So the next day they passed it. But this group, you people are generating issues and trying to find solutions. So it's different. And that's why somebody like me is here coming to join you to have this kind of conversation. Because I have a belief in the people I'm dealing with. So I want to thank you people. I know you have to legislate for this, but if you don't, nobody can do anything to you. For the commitment you people are showing. That's one. Two, the Ombudsman talked about health system being in shambles. That is, in fact, it's not enough to use the word in shambles. The thing is in a deep hole. Deep hole. So, and that hole is covered, so there is no light, so you cannot see. But I also believe that we can open that hole and pull out health. The health sector, when you are discussing the health system, it has what we call 6 pillars. Those pillars are governance and stewardship. The question you ask yourself is, do we have governance and stewardship for health? And my answer is no. Most people in governance and stewardship do not even understand what they're supposed to be doing. Two, human resources for health. I'll keep on, that one is actually the bedrock of everything. Because human resources for health, a lot of people think it's just doctors and nurses. No, it has even financial managers, it has HR administrators, it has all kind of things. Otherwise, if you don't have all those things, you will not be able to run the health system. And actually, that is the greatest problem they have in the health system. Because the doctor thinks he can manage hospitals, it's a lie. Most of these hospitals are failing because the people who are over there cannot manage. They don't have managerial acumen, either as administrators, as financiers, and they don't even go to look for people who can do those things. The third aspect of it is financing, which is what most of us are talking about. Because financing, okay, even if you give us the money and we cannot utilize it, appropriately to achieve the results, we still have problems. So that part of what I think we ought to be doing is, by the time we are leaving tomorrow, all of us should agree, what is it the result we want for 2017 budget? So that that thing will be with us, so that if we don't start to achieve it, accountability we have to start. Because if you made a commitment, like Honorable Usman has said, 6%, which we all agreed in Uyo, if you look at the current 2017 budget, which is about 7.9, that 6% will be about 365 billion naira. That's what it will be. But what was budgeted this year was 304. So it's, it might be very close to it, because you don't need about 61 billion to meet up. But when you bring the 61 billion, where does it go to? Because currently the money we have in that 304 billion, 83% of it is for personnel. So if you bring the other money, it goes for personnel, it's also a waste of time. So that we ought to have to start to say, what does it pay for? It can't be personnel, it has to be services. And that's where you come in, because the thing we and you have agreed through the PAC Revitalization Support Group, most of those things in that chart are services, they are not personnel. So how do we rearrange resources so that they can start to pay for services? And part of what I will pray that we do, I'm still going to speak about this later. You see this PAC, money for PAC revitalization, that 3 billion they put there, they should be talking about 100 billion, not 3 billion. Because if the PACs are not working, even if we make the money available, you cannot deliver anything. So we have to make money. And thank God that the National Assembly has, oversight function. So that is some of the things we have to craft. It's not enough for you to put money in the budget and you go home. You must be able to have that oversight. We see that we'll help you, the CSOs can do that. Because what you won't see in government is, that money, what is the plan? That's, if I put this 10 naira, how can I trace it to make sure it delivers the result? We can work with you to make sure. So that when you are going to the field, you know what you are looking for. So, but it's important that we will start to show evidence that all this work people are going through for the past 1 year, most of you are busy on the road, going for inspections, doing this kind of meetings, it should not be for nothing. There must be something that comes out of 2017 budget, and there must be something we want to do jointly with you to make sure that those things that come out do what they are supposed to do. And once you can do that, the civil society will definitely, civil society is very much more organized now than before. And so I want to commend everybody, because when they called me to say I will come, I said this will be very busy, that you are discussing, you are the committee level now, doing all this work. We didn't have time to come. Then 2 days ago, you said they are coming, I said, that shows a lot of us. So I want to thank everybody that is here. We have become a good place for all of us, so I want to thank you for the ambience and everything. And together, I think we'll be able to achieve what all of us have in mind. Thank you, and God bless everybody. Thank you.